Welcome back, everybody. It's yours truly, Hungover Hermit. Cheers. So anyway, we back with some more Only Ins. This one's coming from a different channel. Because this is an Only in Britain from the channel... What you saying, bruv? Okay, so I'm pretty. Never seen this before. Someone sent it to me when I was asking if there's any other types of only in type of things that y'all want me to check out and do a comparison with. Because I know one channel alone that has 25 from New York. So, yeah, if you haven't seen the other ones already, I did one from my hometown, the most recent one, only in New York. We're talking, well, New York City, they mean. And I did one that was only in Florida. Because, y'all, if y'all ever heard of the Florida Man, Floridians are just known for the dumbest shit. The dumbest shit. I mean, listen, I ain't hating on nobody because New Yorkers are known for the weirdest shit. But it's not even weird to me because I grew up around it. But when I saw that Florida stuff, I think I lost brain cells. I don't know what's in their water. But anyway, but this is only in Britain. Let's see if they could top either one of those two categories or if they go and create a whole category of their own. I don't know, but we're going to find out. My boy sent this to me from over in the UK. So let's see what they got. We're going to give everybody a fair chance. My internet's acting crazy. So hopefully this buffers all the way, but let's try it.
Let's see. No tea.
Okay. See, I knew this was going to happen. My internet is messing up. Time to lower quality. I don't know what started going on with my internet. But anyway, I'll just say off the bat, though. God damn. I'll just say off the bat, though. With the truck, now I've seen stuff like that before. Not in New York City, but I've seen it like traveling across the U.S. I've seen stuff like that. With the bread on that, though, nah, I haven't seen that. And now that I already did my commentary, my internet is still messed up. We will be right back. And we are back, like 5 seconds after I just paused it, because for some reason now it's wanting to start working. It's probably because I'm uploading the last video while I'm recording this. But anyway, let's continue with this musical bread.
Have a fucking look at this. Loading the van up. There's a gaffer stuck on top of the fucking fence, boy.
Oh, that was in Britain? I've seen this one before.
What's he fucking doing?
Man, you want to tell me this is going to keep on happening the whole damn video? But I seen this one before on one of the Aussie Man things. But, yeah, so if y'all, funny as hell channel. But this is really going to keep on happening. All right. I will be right back. Okay, I am back. And I swear to God, if my internet makes me do that one more motherfucking time, I'm just starting this whole video over, and I hate doing that. So let's continue. And I'll try to keep a good mood.
I can't make out if he's hooked or I don't know what he's fucking doing up there. Oh, fucking have a word.
He's struggling. That's what he's doing. He's struggling.
He's proper stuck, Chev.
Unhook the belt.
Oh my god, he's proper stuck.
Unbelievable what has happened here. This car here, LW17 MBX, has been cloned by that number, LW17 MBX. So the lady realized what's happened. She's followed the other car, and then she rammed it into another car. Because these guys apparently nicked their number plate and then put it on their car. And look, it's identical. LW17 MBX and LW17 MBX on the other one. Sorry, the blokes just closed the number plate. But that is exactly what's happened here. Unbelievable. Shocking. So this poor guy got involved in that and they've had to sort of stop him somehow. So the police are taking their time to come in. But the guys that actually had that car just drove off with another car. So they're actually up to no good. So the whole road is blocked off now. We can't get nowhere. So the lady who owns the vehicle was on the phone to the police. That white lady standing there. And I think that's the husband. And then you've got the stolen car, which is now retarded because it's crashed. Wow, you hear this on the news, but you never really think to actually witness it. There you go. This is London for you. Ridiculous.
This is a fucking message for Tyson Fury. If you want...
I actually never really heard of people doing that, like, seriously. And I know people that do some shit. I'm not gonna say no more on that. But, a cloned a license plate. Listen, in that whole situation, I just feel bad for the guy whose car got messed up and had nothing to damn do with it. You rammed the car off the road. Woman, you couldn't have found any other way to stop this car. I hope everybody involved in that go to jail. I hope everybody involved in that go to jail. I don't even like the police, but screw it, y'all. You wanted to involve them after slamming your car into another car in the middle of a street. I hope you go to jail. I hope people that stole the car go to jail. Hope everybody involved go to jail. Y'all doing too much. I get it. You don't want your thing taken, but damn. You messed up somebody else's car. You blocked everybody else. You know, I would have probably recorded it too, but me and almost everyone I know would have also been looking behind us like, okay, this is what's happening. Now can I reverse back up out this street? Because I'm not staying here.
So I'm ready. Anytime, any place, anywhere, I'll fucking spark you clean out. Come to Bradford and fight me. I'll fucking have you. Show them the moves, show them the moves.
Bloody hell, you're too fast, John.
I love you, Tyson Fury. You're the
favorite number!
Wait, did he went from show up, I'ma mess you up, to I love you? I really hope that this is your representation of Britain, because that dude seemed like he was mentally... What's the right way to say it nowadays? Special.
Vincent on the scene, gonna catch all the criminals. Big man.
Who the fuck you think you are kicking me? Who the fuck my phone? My phone's cracked. I'm gonna regret that, pal.
We're now at the Thames, and then all of a sudden, we've now got. Oh, hold on a minute. What's going on here? The two blokes gonna go in. Let's not let go.
Ha ha ha!
swim.
But here we are, he's heading.
For that last one, I was gonna say, I think that happens in like every frat party or every other frat party in the U.S. I don't know, because I've never been in a frat. Hell, I didn't even stay in college that damn long. Because I realized it was a waste of money over here. But, yeah, I've definitely seen people do shit like that. And they usually just drunk and stupid. I think that was just a drunk and stupid thing. But we'll keep on going. I'm trying to see something really Britain special. So far, the only one was the car being cloned. Come on, let's go.
We at Bath Guildhall Market are very conscious that there's a world shortage of masks due to the coronavirus. But we have the answer in our souvenir shop here. And what it is one of these. It's obviously very patriotic. It's a Union Jack. And it fits perfectly, as you'll see. You just pop it over your face like this. You clip the things behind the ears. It fits over the mouth, over your nose. And then you put your hat on. Voila. They're $3.99 for a set of three. We haven't got many left, so please hurry while stocks last. Thank you very much.
Okay, that was new. Because the New York one, I saw people use the panties. They use the panties and stuff as face masks. But never did you see anyone try to advertise that thing. All right, you got me there. You got me there. I don't know how to feel about it, but you got me on that one.
Press this in. Straight out, a geezer stood on the corner of her eye, look. Fucking mask on. Let's go see who this cunt's at. Let's go and see what he's doing. What are you doing, mate?
Just standing around being sinister.
Being what? Sinister?
Yeah.
Scaring kids?
Not intentionally.
I've got my son here.
Yeah, hello.
You've just petrified him. What the fuck are you doing? You gonna take that mask off? Do you want me to come and take it off you? I'd best suggest you fucking move then, mate. Can't be stood around there scaring kids with a fucking mask on your face, can you? What's up with you? What's up? What are you doing?
Why not?
What? You stood on the corner of a road.
Yeah.
With a fucking mask on your face, petrifying everyone. What's up with you?
Why do you think I'm petrifying everyone?
Look at it. It's like a fucking gimp mask. What's up with you?
It's not a gimp mask. Yeah, it's a plague doctor's mask.
A plague doctor's mask. So what? You're just stood on the corner of a road.
Why?
Staring into space.
Why is your child frightened?
Because of you.
So why have you stopped?
Because I've come to take this fucking mask off you fucking...
Look, you don't want to do no...
What's the male equivalent of Karen? Because that guy that literally drove up and stopped to say something was the male equivalent of a Karen. Is it Kevin? I heard one place say it was Kevin. I heard another place say it was Brian. I'm just going to call them male Karens. That was a male Karen. Why you really stop? My son is scared. My kid is scared. So you want to stop next to the dude? And you don't even know what the mask is from. I knew it was a plague doctor's mask. So I'm saying he's probably safer than most of the people out here wearing that. Okay, male Karen. Well, I stop, pull up on somebody, and then act tough, but not really do anything. You want me to take it off you? You weren't gonna do nothing. You know that.
Fucking work, but he wants us to do work every fucking day. Come and do some work. Yeah, like 9 to 5, like all of us.
You're sitting down doing nothing, yeah? What's what you're telling me? Ooh. I'm saying come and do some work, we can get some real money. You're a young man. You're young like me. No, but you're young like me. Yeah, so why aren't you working like the rest of the people? Yeah. Come on, man. Yeah. Come on.
Yeah, he doesn't understand English now.
Yeah, he doesn't understand English.
This is why I'm saying, yeah, when you think about getting rid of English workers, yeah, and you've got people sitting down there getting currency for fuck all, Boris Johnson, sort your shit out. Seriously, it's too much. It really is. Look, I tell you, yeah.
59.
Seen that.
Do we have a check down there? On the left? Yes? Okay, Jody's gonna go up. Jody's gonna go up. Well done. Jody's gonna go up. Second basket down here.
Oh no. That wouldn't be no laughing. I don't know. We got to fight. If I was the one standing there and you just slid into me and made me bust my ass like that, nah, bro. We got to fight. My leg might... His leg is probably messed up. That sounded hard. His knee probably slammed into the front of this. I don't care. I'll limp over to you and start throwing hands. I don't care. Yeah, I'm different.
I'm gonna die in a freezer. I'm not gonna be
the fat girl that's going to. I believe her there. Am I wrong for that? Because my first instinct when I seen that woman like that is I would leave her there. Like, even if I was with her, I'd probably leave her there for a minute. Like, I would at least get far enough away from her to at least let her panic for a minute. And let that, like, moment sit in so she never does it again. At least that. Nah, I'm sorry, bro. Once I seen some dude get on the car, he would have had to be one of the people that was... He would have had to be the car owner. He would have had to be the car owner. Because nah. Now it's not a party no more. I'm sorry. No, get the fuck off the car. I'm going to drag you off by your ankles. Do not be standing on the hood of my car. And I know every single one of my friends would say the same thing. Do not stand on the hood of my car. Other than that, hey, at least y'all partying together. I just hear people blast loud trash music down the street, speeding down the street at like 4 a.m. But, so at least y'all just in the neighborhood, but I could enjoy it. But, oh no, you don't get on the top of my car like that. No, that's disrespectful. That's disrespect. But it's not my car.
Oh, you up. Look at this. Woo! Love a Snapchat, eh?
Stop chasing them kids! He's chasing you! There's a man behind you! You're alright, you lot, you're faster.
Only in South London, look.
Hey, how much, mate?
Free.
For free?
Yeah, free.
Ah, you're a legend. You're a legend.
Yes, sir.
Oh, oh nah. Shit.
Oh, nigga, move.
Oh.
Oh. Oh, shit.
Big boy broke the wall. Come on, that's child's play.
It's a jump. Yeah, bro. Jump. Hey, boy, just jump. Hey, you dying, bro.
That coat is going to end up smelling like straight, like mold. Because you know that it's not going to dry right in the middle. Those types of big coats, they don't dry right in the middle when they get really wet. They're water resistant, not waterproof. When they get really, really wet, the middle, it keeps a smell. Woo! Yeah, you're right. That is only a Britain. I don't know anyone that would ruin their coat like that. Not ruining my coat like that. Hell no. You could fall off a boat. If I got a nice coat on, oh, I'm taking that off before I go in the water to save you. Sorry.
Hang on, John.
What the hell?
John, all over my fucking fishing gear, mate.
Fuck you. Fuck you.
Mate, that's a fucking lot.
I don't give a shit how much it was, you cunt.
That's a tie.
You're gonna fucking stay to me.
That's a tie and wrap there, mate.
Well, I can't even get up, though.
I fucking hate my life.
What's the matter?
You.
What happened?
You're the matter.
Look at all my clothes, John.
Look at all your clothes.
John.
You fucking hit the brakes on this shit. It's like ice on the fucking ear. You can't sit still.
John, they're fucking Hugo Boss trousers sitting there, mate.
What do you fucking want me to do about it, you prick? You're driving like a fucking cunt. Look. Look.
How the fuck are you going to get home? You fucked my van up, mate.
You fucked your van up. You shot me into them fucking tubs of paint, which are, by the way, all cracked.
Mate, that's about 150 because you have a gear there.
They're fucked. It's fucked because of you. I fucking let help me out.
I ain't level you, am I? John, try not to get on my van, mate. I've got to get all that off. just fucking brought it, mate. Alright, I'll leave you in there, alright?
He said, I'm gonna leave you in there. Oh, nah. That's some fighting words. That's some fighting words. I've worked in trucks and vans. Man, and I'll tell you, I remember being in the back of some of those while we was moving. Oh, I used to get so mad at some of my drivers. I'm like, you know I was back there. Why have shit falling on me? Because you wanted to make a hard-ass turn. I got to... You punching shit off of me, throwing it to the other side. You know, like, I was like, why does this look damaged? Because it was about to fall on me, and I beat the shit out of it and threw it across the other side of the fucking truck. Fuck you. I don't give a shit. Be damned if... Well, he was, he asleep back there? Because how you in there and you don't have yourself secured? Like, you know you got to get a corner to yourself and kind of try to pin yourself up in it. I don't know, but that's me. That's me. I spent too many years working in trucks and shit. So I already know. I already know how it is. I already know how it is. But yeah, listen. I don't know, man. I ain't seen enough that really impressed me. I don't think you take either one of the categories. I think that was the police call was petty. Well, not the police call was petty, but running the dude off the road into somebody else's car who had nothing to do with it, that was petty. Man, I would be pissed. I would be fuming if I was a guy. That's the one that still stands out to me, is the poor dude that owned the car that had nothing to do with it. It's like, yo, I had nothing to do with it, and the people got away anyway. Oh, if I was in that like bystander's car, I would be fuming. Like, I don't give a shit what happened to your car or their car or a stolen car. Look at my car, which had nothing to do with this, and now it's fucked. Oh, that's all I would be saying. I don't care. I don't care if somebody owes me money now. I don't care about nothing else. I gotta use this car. You owe me money now. Yeah, I can figure that out later, but somebody owes me money right now, today, right now. Gotta go take this to the shop, get it fixed. Nah, but anyway, I don't know, I'm not surprised. Listen, it ain't no offense. I just never took you British people to be that crazy. At least not compared to the extremes in America. Listen, some places in America, yeah, I definitely got us beat, but those places ain't the places that I'm from or I like to visit. I'm from one of the most extreme places in the motherfucking world. I've been around the world. There's shit in New York City you just don't see elsewhere. So a lot of that shit ain't personal. It just don't faze me. It just don't faze me. I don't know what else to say. But it was a good video. It was a good video. I ain't hating on nobody. Never that. I'm still going to come over there one of these days to visit. Still got party. That party thing, that was lit. The street party with a guy, that was lit. That was something I would get in on. You know, dead, straight up, dead ass. But, all right, let me shut the fuck up because I'm trying to get two more videos done tonight. So, cheers, man. Let me get the fuck up out of here. I'll see y'all on the next. Y'all already know.